Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. In this short video series, we'll be dealing with the classical upscaling of timelines, especially when it comes to footage shot with the RED camera. I like to refer to RED as a flexible format because you can choose the size the image is going to be, all the way up to super large frame sizes. This is just one of many aspects you can change when interpreting RED media. Please be advised that I will be touching on terms that should be familiar to you if you work with RED media. When it comes to working with RED media, the typical workflow is to work with the smaller image size to get the bulk of the editorial done. Once the framework of the edit is together and you're ready to work on your effects, the next step would be to upscale the timeline and the RED media to a higher resolution. In this workflow scenario with smoke, we'll go through one such example. You can use your own RED media to follow along with this video. We'll start off in Smoke's Media Hub, where I'm currently in a folder containing a bunch of RED media. With one of them selected, you can see the resolution of this media in the preview window. The media is 1280 by 675 with a bit depth of 12 bit. To validate how Smoke is reading these settings, switch to the Metadata tab and scroll down to the Debayering settings. Smoke is debayering this footage at a quarter setting. So this is a quarter of the size of the full RED image that is available from this media. If you wish to set your initial debayering setting of the RED media, I advise you to do so before importing your footage. This is because you can apply the setting across a whole bunch of selected clips as they are imported. To change the debayering setting, you switch to the format-specific options. With the RED media selected, you change the pop-up from metadata to debayering. Here is where you can change the debayering mode. We'll be coming back to this when we upscale the edit. Now switching to the timeline tab, we have jumped forward in time to where we have edited our material together with a sequence that matches the resolution of the RED media. I have labeled the sequence as R3D Edit Quarter Debayer. You can see all the settings in the bottom right corner of the record viewer. This sequence comprises of shots edited together, a color correction effect, and a transition. Obviously, your sequences will be much longer, but this is to illustrate the workflow that should be applicable to you. So now you're at a point where I'd like to upscale my sequence and the RED media. It works in a few stages. First, you unlink the media. Second, you reformat the sequence. And third, you relink the RED media back into the sequence at a higher resolution. As a safety backup, I always like to select my sequence in the media library and press Command-D to duplicate it. I'll now click on one of the sequences and rename it. We are going to push the debayering from a quarter to half, so I'll rename the sequence to match what I'm about to do. This is what I have chosen, but you can work with whatever setting you want. Double-click on the sequence to open it in the timeline view. Now you unlink the media. You could select the whole edit and unlink it, but this will also unlink all your audio, and that may not be what you want to do. So I want to just select the video tracks I want to unlink. You can press Command and click to select multiple video tracks if you have them in your sequence. Right-click anywhere over the selection. In the pop-up menu, choose Media and Unlink. You get a warning that you're about to unlink the selected media and you click Confirm. The media is now unlinked, and you get indicators in the sequence showing the unlinked segments. The next step is reformatting the sequence to the higher debayering setting. I prefer to do this in the Media Hub so that I can see the setting from the RED media. To see the settings you need, select one of the RED media clips in the browser. As before, the resolution is displayed in the preview window. To set the media to half debayer, go to the format-specific options and switch to the debayering menu. Now I'll switch the debayering mode to half good. Looking back in the preview window, The resolution is now 2560 by 1350 at 12-bit. This is the resolution we need for the sequence. Select the sequence in the media library and right-click it. Choose Reformat and confirm the warning. In the pop-up window, enable the option to change the resolution. For the width, I change the value to 2560. And for the height, I'll change the value to 1350. Set the resize mode to crop edges, meaning that it will scale the sequence without applying a letterbox effect to accommodate the scaling. The aspect ratio, bit depth, and frame rate will remain the same, so you do not change them. Click Reformat, and the upscaling should be instant. To check the resolution of the unlinked sequence, hold forward slash and click on the clip. You can see the resolution now matches the red media at half Debayer. The whole reason for doing it this way is that you can ensure that you match the resolution and not land up with unnecessary scaling in the sequence with a different resolution. The next step is to relink the red media back into the sequence, but at a half Debayer setting. To relink media back into sequences, you need to switch to the Conform tab. With the unlinked sequence open, you can see that in the Conform list, the audio sources are linked as expected and the video sources are still missing. To start looking for the files we need, click the Set Search Location button. In the file browser, navigate to the folders containing the red media. At this point in the process, you need to tell the red media how it will present itself to Smoke. So I will select one of the clips, and in the format specific options, I will switch to the Debayering menu. The Debayering menu remembers the setting we changed in the Media Hub earlier, but it's always good to double check. To consider the media as a match for the sequence, select the topmost folder containing the red media. As a side note, all subfolders will be scanned if there are any. Click Set, and the media is loaded into the Conform media list. These entries are being scanned as potential matches for the sequence. Now Smoke remembers the red media through a range of properties, including file name, real name, and source timecode. I'll change the match criteria to be based on file name and source timecode. This is how we will link to the files. Looking in the main Conform list, you can see that from the selection of the red media, Smoke has found the matches for the edit. The tick indicates a match, but it's a common mistake to think that the media is already linked. It is not, because it is possible to have cases of multiple matches, and that would need to be sorted out. For this case, it is pretty straightforward. Right-click on any of the list entries and choose Link Matched Sources. Click anywhere in the interface to refresh the window, and you will see the chain icon indicates that everything has been linked up. Switching back to the timeline view, the record viewer is indicating the new resolution setting. If you hold forward slash and click on a segment, you can see that the red media has also been upscaled. So with editorial and basic timeline effects, the workflow is fluid. However, if you have created ConnectFX segments and mixed other formats and resolutions into the node compositor, there are quite a few areas you will need to be aware of and how to deal with them. This will be covered in detail in the next video. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.